Welcome back to KC Talks EV. So one of my fellow viewers actually suggested that I showcase MG Pilot and demonstrate how it works in relation to my Mark 1 ZS EV. So in this video, we're actually going to cover four distinct sections. So first of all, we're going to talk about what MG Pilot actually is in relation to both lane keep assist and adaptive cruise control, and how that relates to the five levels of autonomous driving. Then I'm going to show you how to actually enable that in your center console. Afterwards, I'm going to then show you how it actually works in real life. So we're going to go out on the road and demonstrate it. And finally, we're actually going to have a small discussion about whether it's better to use Lane Keep Assist or MG Pilot and the advantages and disadvantages surrounding both. So just before we start talking about MG Pilot, I do want to make a small disclaimer. MG Pilot is not designed to take full control of the vehicle, even on motorways. I know I've mentioned in previous videos that MG Pilot can take a lot of the hassle away from motorway driving, but during that period, I've always got both hands on the steering wheel and I am in full control, ready to brake, for example, if there was an emergency. So please make sure that you are doing that at all times. I guess that is my legal disclaimer. So without further ado, let's get started. So first of all, MG Pilot is what's known as a level 2 autonomous driving aid. So what this means is, and I will put up a table here to explain all of the different levels of driving aids. So it actually starts off at level 0, so basically no driving aids whatsoever. The only exception to that rule would be things like stability control or, for example, blind spot monitoring. They are both considered driving aids, but in either case, they don't take that much of an effect of the control of the vehicle. Once you level up, so you can actually go up to level 1 with adaptive cruise control. Now, adaptive cruise control is effectively where it will keep its distance between you and the car in front, and it will try and keep that distance while at speed. Level 2 driving assistance, or level 2 autonomous driving, however, is what MG Pilot is. So in this case, it uses both what's called lane keep assist, so it actually can steer you within the lane, and it also uses active cruise control at the same time. So effectively, that's what MG Pilot is. Now, the way it works is it actually has a camera mounted just above the rear view mirror. I will show you some footage of it here. It also uses the radar from the adaptive or active cruise control, which is down here in the bumper. So just to kind of broaden all of the autonomous driving information. So after you pass level 2 autonomous driving, levels 3, 4 and 5 actually are levels of which the driver does not require any input into the controls of the car in certain situations, with every increase in level removing some of that control from the driver. In fact, actually, level 5 autonomous driving is essentially the only driver input you require is to put in your destination, and the car will drive itself. Now, in regards to cars that actually have this technology, the biggest one that has come out recently would be the Mercedes S-Class. So the Mercedes S-Class actually has level 3 autonomous driving, although in most countries this is not legal. What this means, however, is that in any case, you must be in full control of the vehicle at all times when using MG Pilot or Lane Keep Assist or Adaptive Cruise Control. What I mean by that is you must be prepared to, for example, steer out of an obstacle. You must also be prepared to brake, for example. So you basically must keep your eyes always on the road, even though the car is, for example, keeping you in lane. Okay, so in this section, I just want to show you how to enable Lane Keep Assist and MG Pilot. So all you need to do is you need to go into car. In the driving assistance tab, you just need to select lane assist system. Now, I probably should mention at this point that having lane assist on, unless if you press one of these buttons, which I'm going to show you here, it will be on as default. So especially when you turn the car on. Now, this may be actually very annoying because you will have to almost wrestle the wheel if you do not agree with it, especially in town driving, for example. So you may just want MG Pilot on and lane assist off. But if you want lane assist, all you need to do is you just need to select it to on.
And then in the assist mode part, you can either have departure assist, or alternatively you can have full lane keeping, in which you'll try and steer you in lane. I don't have the audible alert on. Alert sensitivity doesn't matter because you don't have it on. And then finally, I don't have vibration alert on, so as far as I'm aware, it will vibrate the steering wheel. So once that's on, your lane keep assist is on. So all you need to do is you need to go to MG Pilot. Now, it will be defaulted as off, but you just need to click on. And there you go, both of them are now set up. Okay, so now I'm on the carriageway. I'm just going to show you how lane keep assist and MG Pilot work. Now, the only difference between what you will see and what I've got at the moment is that because I'm on the carriageway, I have disabled lane keep assist by pressing this button on the indicator stalk. So what we're going to do now is we're going to enable lane keep assist. So all I'm going to do is press this button, and now that green light in the top right hand corner of the instrument cluster shows that lane keep assist is enabled. So that means I can just about take my hand off the wheel. It is going to be kind of like bowling when you've got the barriers up. It is going to bounce between the two lines a little bit, but it's okay. So lane keep assist is activated, but because I've also got MG Pilot enabled as well, what I've got to do now to enable it is this stalk is fully away from me, so just pull it towards you. It now says ACC set. So what I'm now going to do is I'm going to press this blue button to set my speed. So I'm doing about 65 at the moment. And I've actually got lane keep assist and adaptive cruise on. Now, this is the confusing bit. MG Pilot is technically both combined. At this point, there is not really any reason why you need to set MG Pilot on. But if you want to set it, then all you've got to do is you've just got to press, double tap the active cruise control stalk. This green light at the bottom flashes up green, and now you've got MG Pilot on. So I've now got no control of the accelerator pedal, although please make sure that you are prepared to brake at any point in time. I've also got the separation distance to the closest if I want to make it a bit further away. So I'm just coming up to a truck right now. I've just got to turn this stalk away from me, or anti-clockwise, and the separation distance increases. Now, as you can see here, I am not using any regenerative braking. So that is the unfortunate part of MG Pilot now, or adaptive cruise control. Now, in the next section, I'm going to explain to you why it may be beneficial to actually just keep lane assist on, but this is how you would activate both MG Pilot and lane keep assist. So in this section, I'm just going to show you how to activate MG Pilot if you don't have lane keep assist activated. So all I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to now flick the stalk towards me again. It now says ACC set. First of all, set the speed on the active cruise control by pressing the blue button. I am going a bit slow, so I'm just going to flick it up to go up to the nearest 5 miles per hour. Then to activate MG Pilot to get the steering going, all I've got to do is I've just got to flick the stalk twice, and now MG Pilot is activated. Now if I take my hands off the wheel quickly, you should quickly see that yes, the steering wheel is making very small movements. Now it's telling me to hold the steering wheel, so hold it, and then the warning stops. So that's how you activate MG Pilot if you don't have lane keep assist activated. To disable it, just undo it, and then I've now got regenerative braking. And in the next section, we're going to explain why you may want both enabled at the same time, ready to be activated.
So the best way to first of all describe both is that MG Pilot is effectively lane keep assist and adaptive cruise control together, whereas lane keep assist is just lane keep assist. So that's where it will just steer you in lane, and you do have full control of the accelerator pedal. So there is one big reason why you'd want to use lane keep assist over MG Pilot, especially in the Mark 1 or Mark 2 ZSEVs. The main reason why is that, unfortunately, regenerative braking, in which you actually can put energy back into the battery, is not available while using MG Pilot. So in the case of braking with MG Pilot on, it will actually use the friction brakes in order to stop. And what that means, or slow down, and what that means is effectively you are actually wasting quite a lot of energy. Another aspect as well is I find that just using lane keep assist and actually modulating the accelerator, so actually moving the accelerator myself, means I do get better efficiency. What you've got to realize is, although MG Pilot does have a camera, it can't exactly take into account things like elevation. And what that means is you actually will be probably more efficient at making sure that you're keeping the right throttle. So for example, if you're about to go over the crest of the hill, you might lift off a little bit on the accelerator. And then by the time you're on that hill, you can actually lower the amount of response into the accelerator, and therefore you will be a little bit more efficient. Whereas what MG Pilot's likely going to do is it'll actually keep going right up until the crest of the hill. And then as it starts to accelerate, as it goes down the hill, probably put the brakes on. So that's pretty much it for Lane Keep Assist and MG Pilot. So if you liked this video or you found it informative, please give it a like, dislike it if you didn't. By the way, please leave a comment below for any video suggestions that you would like to see about my Mark 1 ZS EV. Please share this video to anyone who hasn't really used MG Pilot or Lane Keep Assist before and would like a little bit of knowledge before they would use it. And I think that's pretty much it. So thank you for watching and talk to you later.